Okay. Let's get this started. Test 1, 2, 3. This seems to work well. Let me just... No. All right, wait a second. Yeah, that's what I thought. Okay. So, let's get this party started, everyone. Let's keep the pleasant music in the background for a bit. Hope it doesn't get too much on my nerves. Herzlich willkommen im Feierabend. Mein Name ist Alex Stefanris. Ihr seid auf dem Twitch-Kanal der Dritte Spieler und ich spiele ein bisschen Go. Ihr werdet euch fragen, was Go ist. Go ist ein sehr, sehr altes Brettspiel. Einige sagen, es ist wahrscheinlich so um die 4000 Jahre alt. Wurde in China erfunden. Und ja. Hat seinen Weg nach Japan gefunden, Korea. Und wird heute von Spielern auf der ganzen Welt gespielt. Alles unter dem Namen Go. Ich habe mir auf der Seite Online Go habe ich mir einen Account erstellt. Und probiere da wieder so ein bisschen ins Spiel reinzukommen. Auch um so meine eigene Spielstärke ein bisschen zu verbessern. Und wieder ein bisschen reinzukommen in das Spiel, ein bisschen zu üben. Ich habe jahrelang nicht mehr gespielt, was schade ist. Ich bin Mitglied im Deutschen Go-Verband. Das ist eine Mitgliedschaft, die ich damals gemacht habe, vor Jahren noch zu meiner Schulzeit. In der Hoffnung, dass ich das ein bisschen an meiner Schule verbreiten kann. Das hat nicht ganz so gut funktioniert, aber ich habe in einem kleinen Freundeskreis in meiner Schulzeit Go gespielt. Ja, da. Sekunde. Mal 13er Brett ist ein bisschen klein. Ich will eigentlich auf dem normalen 19er mal 19er spielen. That being said, this stream will be commentated mainly in German, but also in English. If there are comments in the chat in English, I will respond to comments, questions, and so on. I will do that. Promised. Okay. Let's see if anyone... You know what? Let's do live blitz. When is it definiert? Wait. 24Q. Nice. 9x9. Ich will eigentlich auf einem normalen Brett spielen. Habe schon ein gewertetes Spiel, damit in etwa meine Spielstärke auf dem Server von Online Go auch ungefähr gemessen ist. Wait, is that? And he's gone. 25Q, Nummer 9. Sieht ziemlich nach Beginner aus. Ich meine, für den Anfang macht es durchaus Sinn, auf einem 9x9er Brett zu spielen. Machen wir uns nichts vor, das ist durchaus möglich. Aber ich habe schon ein bisschen Zeit hinter mir in dem Spiel. Aber ich muss so ein paar weitere Taktiken vertiefen. Was erstaunlich ist, dass ich jetzt in der Zeit trotzdem... Was ist das denn bitte für eine Größe? 9x15? Spielt aber ein komisches Brett. Wer macht sowas? Okay, machen wir es anders. Ich erstelle ein Spiel und hoffe, dass irgendjemand das hier spielt. Interessant. Ich versuche mal ein bisschen mehr aufs Zentrum zu gehen. Ziemlich aggressiv auf die Ecke. Das ist interessant. Versuch mal ein bisschen nach unten weg zu expandieren. Aggressiv. Durchaus. Wie spiele ich am besten? Ich kann mir leider auch nicht ewig Zeit beim Nachdenken lassen, weil das Ganze durchaus auch auf Zeit geht. Grenze ich ab und lasse ihm den Raum oder attackiere ich ein bisschen direkter? Ich weiß nicht. Ich benutze mal Kema. Kema ist vergleichbar mit dem Rösselsprung aus dem Schach. Also zwei waagerecht, ein senkrecht oder umgekehrt. Interessant. Ich glaube, ich lasse ihn. Oh, goddammit. Ich könnte versuchen, unten zu einer Reaktion zu zwingen. Aber dann verliere ich oben ein bisschen zu viel Einfluss. Das gefällt mir nicht. Hier ist er schon relativ weit. Muss rechts unten verteidigen. Ich kann versuchen, noch ein bisschen mehr Richtung Mitte oder Rand. Nach links. Ich glaube, ich mache mal die Beschriftung ein, damit ich, wenn ich entsprechend mal was kommentiere oder so, auch eine jeweilige Koordinate nenne. Machen wir es so. Also E10 jetzt als Expansion gedacht, so ein bisschen. Ist noch sehr in der Anfangsphase. Wir sehen aber in etwa, wo sich das entwickelt. Ich kann mir vorstellen, dass Weiß jetzt versucht, auf K4 zu spielen. Um dann noch ein bisschen den Anspruch zu festigen. Dann kann ich nur versuchen, in der Mitte mich noch relativ breit zu machen. Die Frage ist, wie sehr das gelingt. Das macht er nicht. Er greift direkt mit R11 an. Spielen wir das mal mit. Wenn auch nur für eine Zeit. Wohlgemerkt, ich bin kein Profi, also ich habe mich ungefähr so auf 20 Q eingestuft, also von 50 bis 1. Q nach oben sind quasi so die mehr oder weniger Schülergrade, wenn man so will. Und dann fängt der erste Dan an mit dem Meistergrade, 2., 3., 4., 5., 6., 7., 8., 9. Ich habe zwar ein bisschen Erfahrung in dem Spiel, aber ich habe tatsächlich nicht so viel gespielt oder gegen so erfahrene Gegner, dass ich sagen würde, dass ich auch nur ansatzweise irgendwie in der Richtung bin. Deswegen probiere ich mich erstmal so ein bisschen, habe ich mich erstmal so ein bisschen niedrig eingestuft und probiere jetzt quasi so zu schauen, wo stehe ich eigentlich. Und einen Schritt, um festzustellen, wo ich ungefähr stehe, ist 5 gewertete Spieler zu spielen, beziehungsweise generell hier gewertete Spiele auf dem Server zu spielen. Um zu schauen. Oh, das ist interessant. Wir versuchen hier abzuschneiden, hoffentlich hier dem Gegner das Überleben nicht zu ermöglichen. Na, machen wir es so. Ihr könnt jetzt hier quasi bei R16 versuchen abzuschneiden. Ich verbinde auf Q15. Oder er verbindet mit Q17. Dann könnte er sich hier oben ein bisschen Platz verschaffen. Was für ihn wahrscheinlich ein bisschen lukrativer ist. Weil hier auf R15 kann ich noch ein bisschen leicht zum Rand weg hinten bauen. Da habe ich einen guten Anschluss zu der Gruppe. Muss dann wahrscheinlich dann im Endeffekt versuchen. Ja, das war zu erwarten. Mal schauen, ob ich im nächsten Zug vielleicht auf S15 meinen Anspruch hier festige. Dann gilt es irgendwie, hier noch ein bisschen Schadensbegrenzung zu betreiben mit der kleinen weißen Gruppe, die sich hier entwickelt. Dass ich ihr nicht das Überleben ermögliche. Ja, darauf kann es jetzt hinauslaufen. Er wird jetzt wahrscheinlich hier Q12 spielen. Ich werde das Atari auf P12 erzwingen. Er verbindet hier die Gruppe und kann hier probieren zu schneiden. Entweder die Gruppe bei Q13, 14 kann er probieren abzuschneiden. Oder die Gruppe hier um Q11, 10 und R10. Das macht er nicht. Jetzt wird's interessant. Ich kann ja versuchen, da zu entkommen, dann. Kann ich mal versuchen, meinen Einfluss in die Richtung auszubauen. Schon, dass ich erstmal das hier festige. Ist mir da noch ein bisschen zu unsicher rechts oben. Ist also eher so am rechten Rand hin. Rechts oben könnte sich Weiß jetzt tatsächlich gesichert haben. Übrigens auch mein Angebot an die Zuschauer im Chat, wenn ihr euch tatsächlich für das Brettspiel Go interessiert und es lernen möchtet. Ich kann einen Link zur Verfügung stellen, wo ihr euch die Regeln einprägen könnt. Wir können aber auch gemeinsam versuchen, ein paar Partien zu spielen. Und kann euch das quasi so ein bisschen Learning by Doing mäßig versuchen beizubringen, wenn ihr möchtet. Schönes Randspiel. Ja. Atari erzwungen. Aber ich glaube, der kriegt die Gruppe jetzt hier lebendig. Oder auch nicht. Der Schlüssel könnte tatsächlich bei S13 sein. Ich versuche auf S13 zu verbinden. Schönes kleines Gefecht, muss ich sagen. Der Gegner probiert zu überlegen, wie er sich diese Gruppe hier am Leben erhält. Er kann nur versuchen, über T11 die zu verbinden. Dann kann er sich da zumindest die Gruppe sichern. Ich probiere die schwarze Gruppe hier zu verlängern. Wird wahrscheinlich ein bisschen was einbüßen müssen. Ich denke mal, am sichersten wäre es über Q8 oder P8. Und zu versuchen, Weiß am Rand zu lassen. Und mir mehr oder weniger die Mitte zu sichern. Der weiße Spieler antwortet jetzt gar nicht. So, what is this about? Mein Gegenspieler nimmt sich eine ganze Menge Zeit raus. Vielleicht spricht er seine letzten Zeitpakete an. Ich würde gerne tatsächlich mein Spiel zu Ende spielen. Das erste Spiel, das ich auf der Webseite gespielt habe, war gegen Computergegner. Und ich habe es relativ schnell aufgegeben. Und, ja. Die nächsten beiden Spiele gegen 22 und 23 Q-Spieler habe ich versucht fortzuführen. War so Anfang des Midgames, kann man ungefähr sagen. Anfang des Mittelspiels. Und ja, der Gegner hat aufgegeben. Aufgeben ist keine Schande in Go. Es ist auf jeden Fall ehrenvoll und respektvoll, eine Partie zu beenden, bei der man keine Chance sieht, sie tatsächlich auch noch weiterspielen zu können. Also wenn man erkennt, dass man verloren hat, ist es in Go mehr oder weniger als sinnvoll erachtet, diese Partie aufzugeben, anstatt sie weiterzuspielen. Und da gehört auch Erfahrung zu erkennen, wann man quasi eine Partie verloren hat. Man sieht das zum Beispiel auch ganz schön im E-Sport-Bereich, wenn man sich so StarCraft 2 Matches ansieht. Mein Gegner nimmt sich gerade ein bisschen sehr viel Zeit raus. Ich befürchte, er fliegt gleich wegen Disconnect. I think that may be it. He's not responding. Come on. Ich gewinne mit Timeout. Something's fishy. Did the whole server just went down? I hope not. Let's just see where I'm standing. 19th Q. Okay. Nope. Okay. Let's try this. Again. Alexander Zukov. Oh, I'm white. That's an interesting opening. Normalerweise spielt man zur Eröffnung gerne auf die schwarz markierten Punkte auf dem Goban, die bestimmte Namen haben, auf Japanisch zumindest, glaube ich, die ich jetzt nicht mehr im Kopf zusammenkriege. Alexander Zukov. Ich bin mir jetzt nicht mehr sicher, aus welchem Spiel das war. Zukov. Maybe Russian. Das kann man ihm schon mal lassen. Er spielt eine sehr interessante Eröffnung. So was habe ich bis jetzt auch noch nicht gesehen. Es wirkt chaotisch, aber... ja, I don't think so. Interessant. Ich erzwinge mal das Atari, mal schauen, wie er reagiert. Würde mich jetzt nicht wundern, wenn er jetzt auf H12 spielt. Das tut er nicht. Gut, ich gebe die Gruppe hier auf. Schönes kleines Co. am Rand. Yay, thanks for the follow. Moo to you too. Dankeschön für den Follow. Du bist jetzt unsere neueste Platinum Secret Rare Schneeflocke. Maybe not. Zwingt er mich ins Atari? Er zwingt mich ins Atari. Ich mach's ihm einfach. Nimmt sich den Stein. Ich glaube, ich habe den falschen Zug gemacht. Oder auch nicht. Ich wollte eigentlich auf N8. Hab mich gerade verklickt. Vielleicht war das aber die bessere Entscheidung. Ja. Da könnte er mich wieder versuchen, ins Atari zu zwingen. How is he gonna play this? Yeah. Wird jetzt wahrscheinlich auf N3 spielen. Versuchen die schwarze Gruppe hier am Leben zu halten. Das tut er nicht. Könnt ihr relativ einfach lebendig halten. Shit. Das ist keine richtige Treppe. Well, that is one way to do this. He might have saved himself in the corner right there, but he definitely lost this black group. And who knows, maybe I can get the corner too. It's the stairs, or the ladder. Wie man es auch nennt, die Leiter oder die Treppe, aus der gibt es kein Entrinnen. Die bisherigen Züge waren eigentlich ziemlich interessant, gerade auch die Eröffnung, aber jetzt geht's ein bisschen in Anfängerfilm. Hello, me to you too. You're asking me how long have I been playing Go? The last time I played, maybe... actively played, actually, might be about, yeah, 10 years. 10 years ago, Assassin bitte für ein Atari. So. I started playing in my high school senior years, before I did my A-levels and, yeah. I started playing that might be around, wait, 2006, I think around 2003 I started playing. I did for a few years, and it's more popular in Germany than most of Europe. I'm not so sure of that. I'm pretty out of touch with the go-playing scene, if you might call it that way. But yeah, I played it for a while, but I still consider myself a pretty amateur player. I still don't know most of the figures to play. Sometimes having a hard time. Sometimes unnecessarily so. But I think what might be at fault is the manga / anime Hikaru no Go, which you might see here as my pretty background picture. So yeah, I got that going for me. Okay. Ooh, that was close. Let's see. So I think actively playing a bit with my friends around 3-4 times a week, if we came around to actually play it within our school time, played it for a few years and then it slowed down massively. I finished school, I started my job / apprenticeship. And for the main time in the few in the last years, I didn't actually play anything. And now I thought I started again because I discovered a streamer here on Twitch, Go Sagan, he calls himself, and it was pretty fun to watch. He is obviously
10,
very very
9,
advanced.
8, 7, 6, oh. 5, 4. 3, 2, 2, 1.
I'm a bit confused. What's happening right now? Something's wrong. Did the other player pass?
10, 9, 8. 7, 6.
It didn't
five,
recognize my.
Four.
What the hell? Something obviously went wrong here. Something happened. Buggy issues. Yeah, it's OJS. No, I made a mistake because of the website issues. That's unfortunate. And now he's invading here. That's cool, but I won't have it. Pressure. So now I'm really running out of time. No time to think, just doing the first move that comes to mind. Could force the double Atari.
10, 9,
yes,
8,
yes, yes, yes,
7,
yes.
6, 5, 4, 3.
Take it. He seems to be keeping this group alive here. I may have lost most of my white territory there. Pretty much. This is getting dangerous here. Guten Abend, Ryodakum. Ryodakun. Ryodakun. Konbanwa. Ah, that was foolish. Whoa. AlphaGo fan. Then is AlphaGo a website? Is it a website? I don't know. I like Go. Yeah, no. To be honest, I was almost at a point where I surrendered the game, but now he's seemingly doing some little mistakes. I forgot, it's the AI from Google. Profis wie nix Fakeboards. Nee, ich spiele tatsächlich gerade gegen einen menschlichen Spieler. Alexander Zukov heißt der Gute und ist ranked ungefähr auf dem 20. Q. Guten Abend, Blue Master. Viele neue Go-Spieler wegen AlphaGo. Ich muss sagen, persönlich, ich habe damals mit, kam durch den Anime-Manga Hikaru no Go auf das Spiel. Und ja, dadurch bin ich quasi mehr oder weniger zum Go gekommen. Wie so viele andere vor mir auch. Let's see this. Neuscheins. Ich habe tatsächlich angefangen, das Spiel zu lernen. Das war so um wahrscheinlich so 2003, 2004 rum. Also ich spiele tatsächlich Go schon eine Weile, beziehungsweise aber war jetzt eine relativ lange Zeit inaktiv. Und ich probiere jetzt wieder so ein bisschen reinzukommen in Go. Ja, ich Volltrottel. Ich hätte fast das Atari übersehen hier. Ich Vollidiot. Jetzt kann ich hier tatsächlich probieren, hier die schwarze Gruppe am Leben zu halten. Oh. Okay. Aber jetzt, wo du sagst, AlphaGo hier mit der Google KI, da hat's wieder geklickt, was es damit zu tun hatte. Aber tatsächlich spiele ich gegen einen menschlichen Mitspieler und das mit KI ist, oh Gott, Scheiße. Aber danke, dass du eingeschaltet hast, Ryodakun. Ich hoffe, dir gefällt das Stream soweit. Ich werde wahrscheinlich noch ein bisschen heute Abend Go spielen. Dazu leben ist eher einfach für Schwarz. Ja, aktuell schon. Wobei er schon ein paar interessante Züge gemacht hat, muss ich zugeben. Ja, jetzt hat er sich da die zwei Augen gemacht. Theoretisch. Müsste es eigentlich nur hier hin setzen und hätte dann... Aber ich kann nicht hier hinsetzen, weil dann verliere ich die Gruppe. So kann ich bis dahin expandieren und probieren, seine Gruppe möglichst klein zu halten. So, und jetzt hat er zwei Augen. Das passiert. Ja, ich habe schon ein bisschen von der falschen Seite gespielt. Schwarz lebt zu 100%, ja. Richtig erkannt. Hier leider auch. Hier habe ich das zu spät gesehen. Hier gab es eine Phase, wo mein Gegenspieler hier noch expandiert hat. Da hat die Webseite einen Hau weg gehabt. Musste neu laden. Habe dann festgestellt, dass er hier ein bisschen expandiert hat und habe hier eine Gruppe verloren. Oh, klassisch. Jetzt wird's sehr klassisch. Oh Gott, wie war das nochmal?
Ten.
Ich meine, ich kann die Gruppe da einfach verbinden und hab mehr oder weniger automatisch zwei Augen. Das geht. Machen wir lieber mal einen auf den hier. Ein Sicherheitszug. Der verschafft mir hier zumindest zwei Augen. Das probiert er oben langsam dicht zu machen. Mindestens. Der schwarze Stein ist auf jeden Fall schon tot. Also da ist er ziemlich. Hier das Schwarze lebt leider auch. Bin mir sicher, dass ich hier oben tatsächlich noch was reißen kann. Ja, ist okay. Ah, der Zeitgeber. Ich meine, ich habe Komi, aber selbst mit Komi kriege ich wahrscheinlich im oberen schwarzen Gebiet zu leben. Ich befürchte, das kriege ich nicht mehr hin. Ja. Das war's eigentlich. Ich passe. Eigentlich ist das Spiel vorbei. Mein Gegner ist da anderer Ansicht. Ich würde zumindest gerne mal ein Spiel normal beenden. Ich weiß, dass es schon verloren ist, aber ich würde gerne mal die Punkte abrechnen sehen am Ende. Gebiet Gefangener Komi, Gebiet 27. Ja, eigentlich... Ja, P8 habe ich gerade gespielt, ja. Aber bitte nach Möglichkeit nicht jetzt unbedingt was vorsagen. Ich probiere das jetzt so ein bisschen selber zu spielen. Ich habe nichts gegen Backseat Gaming, aber das hier probiere ich tatsächlich so ein bisschen selber für mich.
10.
Nichts für ungut, ist nicht böse gemeint. Aber bitte nach Möglichkeit keine Punkte vorsagen. Es sei denn, ich frage explizit danach. Aber so probiere ich erstmal hier. Oh, 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 oh. Habe ich dann noch eine Freiheit? Dann habe ich zwei. Yeah. Wir können ja mal eine kleine Co-Drohung versuchen und probieren, was passiert. Das geteiltes Gebiet, da passiert erstmal nichts. Zumindest punktetechnisch nicht. Nichts so ungut. Kann auch mein Fehler gewesen sein. Nobody's perfect. Wenn er nicht die einfache Verbindung da wäre, ich könnte hier spielen.
10.
Na dann das Atari. 9.
8,
und daraus, da komme ich 7, nicht mehr raus.
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Ja, so oder so. Bin nicht sicher. Gebiet 11. Na ja gut, aber der ganze Batzen hier. Tod, Tod, töter als tot. Wahrscheinlich. Wie lange spielst du schon, Ryoda-kun? How long have you been playing? Okay, OGS legt mich auf den 19. Q aktuell fest. Bis eingewertetes Spiel gespielt worden ist. Ich muss noch eingewertetes Spiel spielen. Okay. Dann werde ich das nochmal machen. Wobei, vielleicht nochmal ganz kurze Toilettenpause. Und dann geht's sofort weiter. Ich krieg dann Zeit noch ein bisschen Smooth Jazz auf die Ohren. Sorry, gleich wieder da. Thank you. I am back. Rhodes Mark II. Du meinst das Mikrofon? Seit Ewigkeiten vierter Q. Okay. Here's what I do. I play another ranked game on OGS, and then I like to show you something very curious on Steam. There's a little game that is called Ancient Go. Which is... Let me show you. And it's a very curious piece of software because I will show you how the AI in this game is working, or how it isn't. Also, Rhodes Mark II, Jazzstück von aktuellen E-Piano, Rhodes Mark II. Weiß ich nicht. Den Sound, den ich nehme, das ist alles von der YouTube Audio Bibliothek, alles lizenzfreie Musik. Also die kann ich auch im Stream laufen lassen, ohne dass sie irgendwie über Content-ID getriggert wird. Was mir ermöglicht, diesen Stream eventuell auch als Highlight auf YouTube hochzuladen, auf unseren YouTube-Kanal. Ich bin nicht der Jazz-Kenner. Ich sehe, du kennst dich tatsächlich noch mehr damit aus. Ich persönlich bin eher so der Gitarrenhäcksler. So ein bisschen für den Hausgebrauch zumindest. Ein bisschen self-taught Gitarre. Anyway, das hier, Ancient Go, werde ich gleich mal reintun, auch mit der KI, und das ist tatsächlich echt kurios, was da abgeht. Aber gut, mehr dazu später. Okay, let's try another one, and hopefully this works. Spitz Piano, nice. Kann ich nachvollziehen, dass man sich dann ein bisschen was mit der Geschichte befasst. Ich gebe es offen zu, ich habe noch ein bisschen mit dem Öffnungsspiel Schwierigkeiten und dem ganzen Rest. Wie gesagt, das ist das erste Mal jetzt seit wahrscheinlich knapp 10 Jahren, dass ich wieder Go spiele. Also, it's gonna take a while. Probieren wir es mal mit der Mitte. Thank you. curious to see how this match goes. This might be really interesting. Well, it's obvious my opponent has some experience with the game. Now he's building his eyes. Yeah. At least one of them. M11, he would. That is interesting. trying to distract me. Yeah, not working. I'm a complete and utter idiot. Yeah, that happened. Was already there. It would connect it there. Oh my god.
Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, three, two, one. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5.
Okay.
10, 9.
Yeah, it's okay.
7, 6, 5.
Spielt er das Co. aus oder lässt es bleiben? Yeah. No. Good try and pump tricking in 3.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
I tried. Cut the tree 3. Let's see what happens.
Ten, nine,
I don't
eight,
think
seven, six, five.
This worked as intended. Nope. That's okay. Let's just claim this core for us.
Ten, nine, eight.
Oh, come on.
Seven, six.
Shot your trap. One point might be interesting, though. Trying some Atari. He will play. Yes, that was totally foreseeable. Totes. Yeah, two eyes. This group is pretty much alive.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Should I force my luck?
10, 9, 8, 7, 6.
Can I make
10,
much room
9,
for me to live
8,
here?
7, 6, 5, 4, 3.
He will respond with a D8. Yes, he does.
Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4.
Got a call here. Got a call here, but the call doesn't make any difference. Yeah, that's okay. You can do that if you want to. I would really like your input on this one. If you have any input for this game, if you want the game, that's the link to the game, if you want it. Tengen is always wrong. Okay. I'm probably not going to watch the entire review here on stream. I think for about the next 5 or 10 minutes I will watch this review, and then I'll switch to another game, which would be Ancient Go on Steam, which I have some problems with for multiple reasons. Thank you. think I might be really getting back into the game. I think of, yeah, buying myself some literature. Most of the things I've learned in Go are more or less self-taught from the rules and some things I've seen. But I might go a bit deeper. At this point, the game is over. See for future lunch breaks at work if there's an OGS app on the Android store. Too passive. I'm not making many points. Yeah, I try to be safe there. I don't think you can do much. True. It is useful. I will watch the review in its entirety if I got the time. So I'm just trying. Let's see. I think I found an app. I think I might use this for future shenanigans with Go. Vicky on YouTube is good. Well, thanks for the recommendation. This looks like a good YouTube channel. Thank you very much for the recommendation, Cut the Tree.
This looks good. It really does.
I'm away to now watch some light. Yes, ahead of me play. Alright, thank you for joining. Thank you very much for the review. I will watch it in its entirety at a later time. I will now see if I can do some things with a Steam game. This one. And I'll show what is a bit wrong with it. Also in terms of AI. Okay, this is strange. Online Go web app isn't working properly. God damn it.
Well, at least the app was free. Maybe it has a problem with the game launcher. I don't get it. It's not working. Oh, come on. I'll try this another time. And I'm back to 20. Yeah, that's what I guessed. Just see. Okay, let's try Ancient Goal. Let me just
Okay. Let's do some... Looks nice. Okay, let's return. Oh God, no. That music. That music! Okay, just having a quick look at the dashboard. It's not there. Okay, I guess it stays like this for now. Play the computer. Let's try this on easy, so you can see what is wrong with this game. Looks pretty nice so far, doesn't it? Okay, let's have him back. Shindo Hikaru-kun. Okay. We're playing against a computer, just saying. Who, in the right mind, would play this? It's not AlphaGo, that's for sure. Also, I don't like the sound of... when the game does something like that, it's really hard to not... just scream in anguish. Not really trying at this point, I'm just trying to secure myself as much space as possible. There's no real strategy. Okay, Tengen is always wrong, we remember that. From now on. So we got no time limit, which is nice, but I would prefer if I could actually, well, try to enforce some kind of time limit there. This seems completely random. He's not responding as, like, ugh. Why can't I adjust the Komi to 6.5? That's also one thing I don't get. He doesn't even respond to the Atari. Let's see AI on easy. Let's just see how many points I can get out of this. At this point, I'm just curious. I'm not playing seriously right now. This is me versus the computer, and the computer is a complete knobhead. What is this? Christ almighty, look at this. This is hilarious. I don't even have to try. I can't take this AI seriously. I can't. I just can't. Just look at it! Gah! Still no response to the Atari. I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I got 7 enemy stones in Atari. And the AI just doesn't give a fuck. This is madness. Thank you. You can't play a real game with this. You see what is happening. Wait. Nope. Still stupid. Don't even need to bother playing normally. Look at this. It's completely shit. I'll try now and capture as many enemy stones as humanly possible. Because apparently, the game doesn't give a shit. Good. Nicely done, two eyes. Oh, Christ Almighty. Black wins by resignation. No shit, Sherlock. That was the easy AI. Let's see how this goes on medium. Tengen is always wrong. Except when you're playing against an AI this stupid. At least it tries some decent cornering. I gotta give it that. Why playing against AI? Because I just want to demonstrate the lack of intelligence from this particular program. And now I have to play against real players. I know that. Why playing against such a weird AI? Because I just wanted to show what this AI in the game Ancient Go on Steam is actually like on Medium. I don't know if you sticked around long enough to witness the AI on the easy setting. It's weird. It is really, really weird. You see the problem. It's in some ways very straightforward, in some ways very lacking. At least I might say it is probably very good to start with for training. Very basic. It works, but not much beyond. At least it works. Let's see if I can get one or two more games running. Is it working? Hello, GG Petty. Good evening. This doesn't seem to work. Why ever? Where is it? Let's take a look. Cut the Tree was helpful to provide me a review of the game. Cross game is usually better for white because of Komi. Wait, let's make this smaller so you can actually read what he had written. Komi is more useful in games with less territory, but totally playable even as black. A terrible review. Oh, come on. Don't be this modest, please. I really appreciate the work you put into this. For me. Really, thank you. Let me back off. Cross game better for why didn't you? Me neither. It's the first time I've really put much time into playing since about 10 years, which is not an exaggeration, but pretty much the truth. This is what I played, this is what I maybe should have played. Kick when we have a stone around, C9. Instead, we got. What's your OGS name? My OGS name is Alex T. Fenris, which is the same name as displayed here in stream. More normal, but what had been played was this. Maybe I should try that one. Maybe. Well, that was quick. Tengen is always wrong. Yeah. Also this one, I really should have attacked the upper left corner a bit more. Instead I played this, very loose around here. Tengen is fine if you have a plan with it. Yeah, my plan, also I thought, was to establish a connection to the right border and to the top. Also because I didn't play here on the Hoshi, on the upper middle Hoshi right there. The early game it goes corners, approach corners, sides, and then center. Too small, you want to play on the open side of the board. Yeah, I tend to do that when I c- connect a long line and then try to cut just a little bit into enemy territory. So he has to force me into Atari. I strengthen there. Done. More or less. I mean, could always gone this way, but yeah. I wanted to force his hand a bit, I think. R6. Another spin-off here. What I played was this. If I tried D18. No, E19. You mean like there? That would be... Yeah, the thing is, from where I seen it, connecting here, oh, you have a good point there. I didn't see this. Either way, this way or this way, Atari. Yeah. Like that. That's a good one. I like it. I need to learn to read a few moves in the future. This is a skill I'm still lacking in Go, which is what I'm realizing now, returning to the game after about a 10-year break. Similar result, better for black. Yeah. Totally agree. It's a good possibility. It's very nice. Thank you very much, Little Try. I really like it. End game. Let's try to go on. That is the move I should have made according to cut the tree. And this is the move the my opponent makes. Trying to connect. And now he's beginning to wreak havoc. This was just me trying to keep the connection established, so no cutting there, because white playing at f13, that could have cut me off and easily trying to kill this black group. Apparently my opponent is a far more experienced player than I am. You've seen some things clearer than I have. Instead of F13, does J13 work? Third game. This was actually, I believe, my... Wait. This was my sixth game. That is, if you don't count the game I had versus the AI. Is J13, if white connects on, white can connect, that is interfere on F13, and can really try to cut off this group. What could have black done to from this point? What could have black done to keep this black group alive? Forcing the Atari for white. Trying a very loose connection here. White could have some problems cutting through there. I could try to make enough room to live. The thing is, here or here, he can cut. The thing is, at this point, this white group has far more liberties than this black group. And I can't possibly think to cut here. Cut off the little white group in the upper left corner to keep this black group alive. H17. H17 for black, you mean? Wait a second, let's make this a bit easier. So, okay. H17 for black. White shouldn't survive there. Yeah, I might... J17. J17 for... Now wait a minute. J17 for black. Okay, we got from... This was the screw-up I had in the actual game. Now this is the thought if I had not connected. To keep this black thing here alive. My first thought would be this. Trying to expand a bit. A sort of loose connection. The H17 was the suggestion from Little Try. J17 seems a bit interesting though. It can easier connect to K15, I believe. Although I'm not entirely sure how that plays out. I like J17 a lot. White can't escape now. From black J17, white can't escape. Now what would be the best move for white here? Now from white's standpoint, I see how this could be difficult for white. White could try to expand this group, this little group here, with J14. Wouldn't seem very likely, but then could black force the Atari for G16? And black would survive. What about this? Nah, Go is not an easy game. I agree. Now I see. Lights on. So many lights on in my brain right now. Still, what I am still thinking is that this black group still has fewer liberties than these white stones, which could be easily connected. It has its complications. J16, white connect, when connect, white descends. Is fine and white is overplaying. That might be it. Well, let's not dwell on the ifs of this particular situation. Let's play how this let's see how this one plays out, because this is what I did, trying to ensure the life of this group. Gotta find the killing moves, yeah. Let's see if I can get finished a bit further through the review. It's about 1 a.m. in the night and getting a bit tired. But that shouldn't be an excuse. But Plating and Better have won. Maybe. That was me trying to force a reaction out of my opponent. I thought before he tries cutting too much into this area, I might actually try to attack him in sort of way. Yeah, this is classical me. K1 should have been somewhere big on the board. Safe on the left, yeah. what this move is weird, which is pointing direction. Okay. Sorry, I've been looking at that move and I just tried to imagine what was your thought behind this, because it's not really, it's a very, very loose connection, which would have been a bit, let's see, in maybe after seeing this and your alternative, I might have played this one. Maybe. I might have played this one. Because white could easily try to cut off the black group here, trying to stop my expanse to the right side, but I could then work out to try to strengthen the connection between the upper right corner and the right side. No, 15 is too high. And 17 better. I think at this point, white clearly demands the upper right corner. And at this point, I definitely lost this area here. Obviously, the opponent liked 017 also very much. So I think you're in good company there. L15 was very bad. Yeah. I made a lot of bad moves in this game. I won't deny it. Yeah, 014. Slow. At this point, P15 was pure desperation to try to keep a little bit of control of the right edge here. This was just a safety move to ensure that he doesn't try to boldly cut into here or here. Okay, enjoy your meal, Krakatok. Thank you for the input. See ya. And now he's trying to do the same. And again. And now I'm trying, and now here I'm trying to lose the lower left, lower right, sorry, lower right. He's trying to cut off. I force the Atari, he gets out. And chaos ensures. What do we got here? Thank you very much for the friend request. What, you move dice? Yeah. Because this... And it's dead. That happened. Hello, Kalik 3. Yeah, a bit. I tried to get back into the game. I haven't played Go, or Baduk as it's known in Korea, for about 10 years. And I tried to get back into the game. There is a good... Wait a second. Is a good website I can recommend. P9 bad shape. Yeah. This move at least ensures a bit that this stays alive, actually. P9, Q9, 8-9 shape. That's the empty triangle, yeah. Q10, not Q8. I know what you meant. I know what you meant. This shape here. This three black bastards over here. That was me trying to force a bit. I think this three stones, J12, K10 and L8, make a good loose connection. Then he's trying to reinforce there. Yeah. I will remember the empty triangle. White shall die in the middle. Variation. Alternate term power triangle. You're welcome, Kalik. You're welcome. Yeah. Trying to force the Atari. And here I'm trying to close the connection between these. What is this? Playing, what is it? Ah. But what if white connects here? Oh, wait. Another empty triangle. Although a bit bigger. But it's... I played this game against another player called CQD. And I lost the game by about... I lost the game with a point difference of 140.5 points. That was... complete and utter disaster. And I'm just reviewing now the game I played. Because cut the tree 3, he is still here in chat. He was kind enough to provide a review. And I'm just now watching it, and now we're nearly everyone here in the chat has a look at this and trying to analyze a bit and helping me get better at the game, because I am still learning and it seems I have a good way to go, but that's not bad. It's always good to learn some new things, some new stuff. I'm just thinking about this variation. this. The connection wasn't wrong. My idea was sort of right. This. Yeah, would have killed it easily. And White tries this. Pretty much dead. Okay, let's look back at this. Even now, with the next move. Yeah. Could also protect the cutting point and then proceed to kill off the white group. I see. Yay! Thanks for the follow, Scardmaker! Your newest Platinum Secret Rare Snowflake. That will be rewarded with some... nice Frankenface Z emotes we got in our chat. See where the next bigger screw up. Yeah, I was completely oblivious to this one, but this is pretty much dead. This is the point where I really should have connected here. But this killed off this. Big screw up. I really messed this one up. White wreaks havoc in the lower right. Okay, now he's thinking. What was it? P12. You're very welcome, Scardmaker. Thank you. That's the wrong move that kills off the entire group. I see that. Yeah. Yeah. Yep. It's dead. It's dead, Jim. Oh my God. I really need to get a eye for this kind of situations in the game. Okay, let's try to skip forward to the next bigger screw up. Too passive, yeah. Not making many points, but I think you can do much anyway. Has so much on the left and right. Agreed. He's got this area. He pretty much secured this area. I didn't want to risk play here because this would have been easily cut off, and I would have had a last chance to claim this territory here. And now he pretty much builds a wall around it. The thing is, White could have played this one better, I believe. Wait a second, let's try that one. I just got a thought. Let's just try to think it through. Connecting, trying to cut off. This is a website. This is onlinego.com. Nabero. It's a very old board game. This is a sort of website application for this board game. It's literally thousands of years old and was, I believe, invented in China back in the day. It's known as Weiqi. I don't know if I pronounce it right in China, Weiqi, Baduk in Korea, and Go in Japan. So let's think, could White have played better than this? I mean, protecting this area right now. Make the cut. It is my game. I played this earlier tonight against another player, and cut the tree three. who is probably in the chat right now, was so kind to offer to do a review on the game, and when just now going through the replay and through some of the scenarios. It is a game I actually played. That I don't know if that was the best decision there. So what would have happened if I believe White Chi. I still don't know if I pronounced it right. God damn it.
Wei Qi.
I think I got it. Wei Qi. I got it. But thanks, Godmaker. Yeah, I thought White could have played G7 a bit earlier. This is the point where I sort of expected White to push me into Atari. But maybe White would have even gotten a stronger hold on me if White tried to loosely connect this group a bit in to the middle with G9 or H9. But enough analyzing the opponent, let's analyze my shortcomings a bit more. Yeah, that's the move I anticipated there. It happened. Yeah, this was absolutely stupid from me. Maybe I should have tried this instead. D6. Then trying to keep this thing as alive as possible, either D8 just an idea though.
Yeah, that was stupid. Trying to put some pressure. This was wrong. I should have played this instead of this. Because I lost this. I really should get to sleep soon. Let's fast forward to the next screw up. So stupid. A little code there. It captures, of course. More coffee. Yeah, I think I don't want to mess up my sleeping schedule too much. I got this week off work, but next week I have to get up early in the morning, so I don't want to mess up my schedule too much. And at a certain point, coffee doesn't work for me anymore. I could gulp down some cans of Monster Energy or something, and I still would fall asleep. But I'm feeling really tired. Atari there, but I'm realizing he can very easily build two eyes there. He's very careful. And now he's building his little trumpet, and no more cutting in there. The thing is, would I have the possibility to do something here? Probably not. Although this one? I don't know. Just an idea, though. Finishing the corners. Here again. Showing some stupid little Atari. And he looks right through it. Of course.
And that was about the end of the game. And then I lost. To be quite honest, I lost much, much earlier. But that was one game I really wanted to play until the end. A lot of stuff I could have done better, especially now that I've seen it. Hello, Rostafarian. I like your nickname. I really like it. Well, it's 1:36 a.m. in the night, and I think I might go to sleep. So basically, this is the end of the stream, actually. I hope you enjoyed my stream. I really, really enjoyed you being here in chat and helping me and giving a bit of tips, advice for my playing, for my shortcomings. I really appreciate it. It's nice that that the game Go has such a great community. Thanks for the follow, Rose Safarian. You're now newest Platinum Secret Rare Snowflake, and you'll get also a bunch of FrankFAZ emotes in chat. I hope you have FrankFAZ, then you can totally witness the awesome emotes I made for the channel. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thanks for the follow. I didn't thought much of it when I thought, let's just play a bit Go and stream it, but I think I might do this more often than I thought I would. I will definitely return playing Go, but I also play a lot of other games on this channel. Dark Souls 3, for one thing. I also like to play a bit, what was it? Yeah, Wrestling WWE 2K17. And lots of other games. So, mainly we stream in German and in English. Mostly it depends on the viewers. If I feel there are more English-speaking viewers in the chat than German-speaking viewers, I switch to comment in English, and vice versa. So thank you again very much. Thank you for joining me. I hope you all have a wonderful time. Take care of yourself. We'll see each other, I hope, very soon. I might think after sleeping, having breakfast, morning coffee, I think I shall play a bit of Go again. Again, thank you very much. Have a wonderful time. Have a wonderful evening, night, relative daytime where you are. And we'll see each other next time. Goodbye. Thank you very much. Thank you.